Just out for a rip, are you, bud?
Are you, bud?
Just out for a rip? Let's start with, well, it was going so well, fellas. It was going so well. And then the Flames decided to do some winning. That green line is the top five. All of a sudden, they're ninth, and they could finish 10th if they did something so stupid as to collect 3 points in the next two games. I'm looking at you, Kuzmenko. Settle down. Kadri, whoa!
Savvy, back to the original.
Yeah, go back to the old power play.
Yeah,
save that. Where's Lindholm when you need him?
Get the rune dog out there.
Straight.
Equal opportunity ice time tonight.
Here's the details from Pike. Remember, fifth wasn't out of sight a week ago. But win here, win there. Seattle needs to earn more points than the Flames. That's not ideal. Seattle has two games left. The Flames have two games left. And the Flames have a tiebreak the wrong way. So you need to do less than the Kraken, who've got a tough schedule.
So Seattle better get Kraken.
Seattle. Oh, Jack's doing the show.
Whoa, did you say? Hey, what are you saying?
All right. Shopping. What's the matter, Jack?
Let's give it a spin. Now the Flames down to 5% chance. Stinking Ottawa. Get out of here. God damn it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Chicago.
Yeah, it seems like a likely outcome there. Yeah.
And
This
could be no fun.
No, this is not must-see TV.
Wherever, now here, this off-air conversation on air. Should be. They haven't announced the date or the time for the draft lottery yet, but it will be the second round, usually an intermission of a Eastern game. So let's call it 6 local. I think we should get anyone that's ever done an afterburner or a barn burner, and we all live stream and feel the pain together.
But here's the thing, because you know how they do it.
They count up.
Because they count up.
Yeah. So
how far?
16, 14, 15, 14, 13, 12. Right. And then it's like, uh-oh, the Flames could be 11 if two teams behind them win. Okay, they're not 11. Now you go to 10. You're like, please don't be 10. Please don't be 10. And then if they're not there, at whatever respective position, we will know. They will be drafting first or second overall. You're ready for this disappointment. We have to live it together, Dean.
Right.
So you love misery. This is perfect.
A play-in tournament would be boring. Us doing a live stream of that, exciting.
I don't know that it was a one versus the other, but they are going to do the draft lottery.
Here's what we should do. We're all going to get together.
Depending on the consumption of alcohol, we can make anything.
I was going to say, we can empty this beer fridge, put a shift on that, and watch the feel pain together.
Because they just rattle through those bottom ones. At 16, Buffalo. Ottawa. They just kind of rattle through. It's like, okay, well, no movement there. And then what is it? Who was the guy that blew it last year?
You blew it!
Going into the commercial break. Yo, so Columbus.
They did have a screw up last
year. We haven't done Columbus yet.
Whoopsies.
Kevin Weeks, that's who it was.
Weeksy.
It was Weeksy.
Weeks, he's big as a house right now.
Is he?
Is that right?
Oh,
yeah. Hey, you know what? Good on him.
Yeah.
No.
Why not?
Uh-uh.
No?
Uh-uh.
Insulation?
Lots.
Living in Manhattan.
Great restaurants. This is what Frank was saying. It's not his fault.
It's not his fault. Not his fault.
It's not your fault.
So much good bread out there. They know how to do bread there.
Kidding me? You get one of those sandwich shops downstairs from us?
If you had a New York style pizza place on this block?
Well, they'd be closed because of the construction, but.
Well, other than that.
I would walk through the construction to get there. Yeah.
See that article in the paper the other day?
No. Yeah. Is there paper? They still exist?
Something like that.
Crazy.
What did they say?
That's awesome.
I'll share it. The old bakery down the street and the.
Yeah.
They're not very happy.
No kidding.
Really, eh?
Yeah.
Weird.
Yeah.
May have hurt the numbers.
Yeah. Business down considerably.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wait till the bike lanes open up, though, because bikers love bread.
Oh, yeah. They pop in real quick, grab a coffee on the.
Yeah, so you get the little cup holder there.
For guys like you and me that live in the south part, we'll just hop on our bikes and wheel in.
Yeah, shouldn't. It's easy.
Yeah.
Up the river.
It'd be a fun bike ride up the river.
No, great. It wouldn't.
What? Come on, awesome. All right, let's move. 3 stars of the week were announced yesterday. Oh, and there's Nazem Kadri. Good company, bud. Hey, bud. Hey, what's buddy. Kuzmenko, hey, pal.
Got to do, you know?
It's pretty darn good. 2 points a game. Nas has been great. Roman Josi's been on a heater as they Well, they've been sensational the second half. And Austin Matthews, I mean, I guess if you like goal scoring, he's having an okay year.
Pass the puck.
Puck hog.
Puck hog.
We have a hog later in the Pinder report, by the way.
Oh, so, delicious.
Yeah.
A sweat hog?
Some fat sweat hog. 85 points in 82 games for Roman Josi.
One of my favorite lines ever.
Sensational.
Ever.
Well, and it's this season. It was around this time of year. It was round one against the Sharks for the Oilers and some sweat hog.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then, yeah, the guy in Anaheim as well, Burl Ives or whatever. That was a bad year for fans.
Burl Ives.
Yeah. Whatever the guy's name was.
I tried to grab that. It's just the audio is so bad. It's from so long ago.
Yeah.
Just couldn't.
Someone's peeled it off a VCR.
Yeah.
You know, adjust the tracking.
Some fat sweat hog is getting into the ring. Jess.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Jess. Come on now.
That's Adrian Adonis. It's not some fat sweat hog.
Jess. Look, take a look at the Canucks.
All right.
Yeah, there's your third line center, Elias Lindholm.
Good job.
Attaboy, Elias.
You can never get your paws on a third line center. I mean, I'd give away a 40 goal guy first to third.
Boy, we just crush, eh? We just
You know what? I don't mind crushing him because I think he pouted and he overplayed his hand and I don't think he was good about it.
I don't think he's trying to be bad. It's just not going well at all. And he might not be a player. Like, he's at that age now where it'd be a little early, but it wouldn't be the first time a guy slowed down real quick.
Even Coleman kind of buried him after he left.
He did.
We had some guys that didn't want to be here.
Zadorov, for sure. Yeah. Yeah. Let's keep looking.
How's your snooter?
Just leaking. Faucet, baby. Faucet.
Damp.
You want a high five?
Moist.
Quinn Hughes, Phil Peronic, who needs a contract. That's their top pair. Soucy's healthy. He's missed a lot of time this year. He is with one of the two giraffe lobotomies. That's Tyler Myers. Zadorov, the other on the third pair with Ian Cole. There
you
go.
You hate Tyler Myers.
You hate Tyler Myers.
I don't know
what
Tyler Myers did to you because he's done nothing but try.
And play.
Yeah. Plays every game.
Perfect third pair defenseman. That's what he wasn't want to pick. Trouba, Bufflin, Myers. All right, shot D. They just paid him to be a three, and that's not what he is.
That's his fault?
Nope. He's got a good agent.
Oh.
It's Matt Stajanitis. You got a good agent. That's all.
So you hate Myers?
Nope.
Because teams wanted
because he took a good deal.
No, again, I don't hate Myers. Yeah, like I said, he's a really good third pair defenseman.
You called him a draft lobotomy?
When he and Zadorov play together, that's the giraffe lobotomy pair because it's about 13 feet of poor decision making typically. You saw Zadorov here, right?
Yeah. Is Myers at that level? I would put Myers.
Not this year, but he has.
I think Myers is just a big. Maybe underachieving for where he was drafted, but just a big ice chewing defenseman.
You want to talk big ice chewing defenseman?
Yeah, I do.
This draft class is locked and loaded full of them, and NHL Central Scouting released their final rankings for the NHL draft.
It's going to be this final. Morning. Playoffs aren't even over in junior hockey.
Well, the teams will continue to adjust, but for the sake of Central Scouting, this is what we're looking at. Now, is it Siliev or Siliev? I don't know, but he's kind of got the old, I'm 6'7", and I'm playing in the K, which are really impressive things to do at the age of 17.
Monster.
Huge.
Yeah, this guy's a monster.
Demidov's a forward that has piled up some stupid numbers in the junior league there. And then, there's a lot of D. You see 4D in the top eight out of Europe?
Would that be Sammy Hellenius's kid, do you suppose?
I don't know if it's Sammy. Let's check.
Adam Gurek check.
And then the name we're all looking for, let's to the North American side. You can scroll and find him, Rhett. Where is he?
Who?
What do you mean, who?
He's too far away from the screen.
I can't see this.
Now, who would you be interested in the North American skaters, Rhett, in this
one? Well, I was looking at the guy with the Tigers jersey on. I'm like, who the hell is that?
Lidstrom.
That's Caden Lidstrom, yeah.
He's scored at the torrid pace, but an injury shortened the season. A monster. I think already over 200 pounds at 6'3 or 4. And... there he is, TJ Ginla at 9 in North America. Seems low.
See, if I were at home, I could play the thing. But I'm not at home. I'm here.
What thing?
Woo, woo, woo. No.
Well, what else did you play?
What's his ranking?
9.
Oh.
You guys keep wanting me to come in here.
I mean, you could take that thing.
We do miss a lot when you are here.
Could have like fart noises and play.
Still do that here.
9. Yeah, Tej up to 9. Now again, that's North American. So then you factor in the international slash European skaters.
Squash them together.
If you know, so
central scouting, he probably comes in at sort of like 12 to 15.
Yeah, which is where he'll
go higher than that.
Yeah, I think. Blood, the you know, the, his pedigree. Blood, the blood that runs through his veins.
There's some pedigree there.
Yeah. Can we go back to the North American skaters there real quick? Just because we focused on Tiege immediately, but there's a lot of really good players. A lot of really good players there.
Until they're not.
Yeah, that's correct. But as of today, all the information we have, Bell Russian defenseman playing at Michigan State. Levshunov's had a monster year. Ziv Buyum, there's a name for you. DU, national champ. And Perrick and Dickinson, the two D-men in the O that you like this Dickinson kid, right?
I've heard good things about old Sammy Dickinson.
Also of note, Berkeley Catton has piled up massive, massive numbers. The question is, will he be a center at the next level? Can he be like a Suzuki point-sized centerman? Or is he slide to the wing? And if so, where does that put him? I don't know. Interesting. And they've got Tiege listed at center, despite him not playing center this year. That's odd. Weird. Okay. We'll move.
See, the thing is, Iginla is listed as a centerman everywhere.
He's at forward at a lot of places.
He's center on the Western Hockey League website. He's center there. He's
playing the wing.
So I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just texting Amateur Scouts.
I know.
You should text his dad. Like, he's in the middle. I texted a scout. Like, how many of your viewings has Tiege played center ice? Zero. Okay.
Yeah. So there's some, information. There's a breakdown somewhere along the line.
Could he be a center? I don't know. Maybe.
Oh boy.
Let's go to changes in Buffalo. Rhett, this is your opportunity. Finally, we've had a good time on the podcast with you, but it's time for change.
Rhett's timing is shit. Hey,
is it?
He's been back in town for 2 days or whatever it is. Fire the coach in Buffalo. You're in Buffalo all season.
I'm packing my shit.
Nothing happened. Hey, last year you're in Buffalo. Sutter. Out. Treliving out. You come back here.
He didn't even answer my call.
Oh, I know.
So here is, let's stay with Chris Johnson here. 13-year playoff drought, 7 head coaches. Ruff, see ya. Rolston, see ya. Nolan gone. Bilesman, no. Housley, nuh-uh. Kruger, see ya. Granato, see ya.
I don't remember Ron Rolston.
Yeah, it was very short.
Feels intro-y.
Very short.
Head coach nonetheless.
And Ruff had just been there for 20 years. So,
yeah.
I mean, let's go back. Let's take Ruff's, how long Ruff was there, which would be, so in 30 years.
I was going to say, so that's 13, which would be the same as 20.
And he had
or 25.
He had at least seven. I think he was 17 or 18 years. So in 31 years, they've had 7 coaches.
So it's like when you compare the Steelers coaching to other teams.
This is just that Chris Johnson trying to make things look bad.
There's more. You know, Justin Bourne watched him a bit and had this to say. Casey Mittelstadt got traded. Oh, sorry. This is the money.
Yeah.
Extension just kicking in. So that's $8 million to not work. How do you get some of that, Rhett? Jesus.
Great work if you can get it.
What's your move if you've got 2 years to make $8 million and maybe you want to get into coaching afterwards, but you certainly don't have to rush and you want to keep collecting? Are you just straight to an island right now, or what are you doing?
I think so. Yeah.
Feet in the sand.
There's real good fishing out of Costa Rica right now.
Is that right?
Oh yeah, really good.
Part of those blue zones. People live longer. They're healthy.
There's a big Marlin tournament coming up.
A which?
Early May.
A what tournament?
Marlin.
Marlin.
Oh, a fishing tournament.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wow. Jeez.
So
I'd love to go fish.
Remember the most scathing review I heard of the Sabres this season came from Casey Mittelstadt. This is Justin Bourne tweeting, who went to Colorado and simply said, "Boy, they practice hard here."
My question is, are they going to clean house?
It was a video coach and assistant and John Granato. The GM's only been a couple years in. I like some of the things he's done. What else would there be to do? Are there more coaches you would want to see? Or
well, how do you? I mean, and I guess if you're bringing in a new coach, he's going to have some say on who sticks around.
Because wasn't Granato the interim who then took over the head job?
He's had some success. It's just been a really bad year. They've not looked good at all, and they had expectations this year. Last year, they had that incredible run. Tage all flirted with 50.
Like, I guess I'm just thinking in terms of Kevin Adams. He was there before Adams, and Adams kept him. It's not really an Adams hire.
I believe that's correct,
right? So this would be his opportunity to go and get his guy in theory, although that guy's got to want to come to Buffalo.
It's a good young team. It's positioned.
I agree.
Yeah. And with coaching, there's 32.
Yeah.
I mean, there are certain guys that can have some say, but a lot of guys that would be dying to
get. Like Craig Berube feels like a fit, but he feels like a fit in every opening, doesn't he?
Yeah. He's not going to Buffalo.
No.
I feel like.
I don't think so, because I think that Pegula learned too that if you try to overpay to get a guy, that's not like. Remember, he was in on Babcock?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
We're going to pay the best.
They settled for Bilesma.
That should have gotten Babcock.
Yeah, and I mean, Joel Quenneville's popped his head out of the sand.
And
here.
Don't
he wouldn't go to Buffalo.
He wouldn't. And again, we're waiting for Ottawa, and there'll be some teams that, you know, like I think LA probably is going to solidify and not be Hillier Smith.
Don't just push under the rug that $4 million either.
Oh yeah,
right. Like well, that. The,
yeah. That, yeah, like that if somebody told me Ryan Huska was the 32nd highest paid coach in the NHL, I'd be like, yeah, probably, because mm-hmm. Sutter is making four.
He's not in the top 10, I can guarantee you that.
Yeah, okay, and so, that's what they did with Glenn Gullitson when they were paying
can
we go back? Bob Hartley, and then when they got rid of Bill Peters, that's what they did with the Jeff Ward. Like, if you're paying a guy a ton of dough to not coach, you
first
often
of all,
won't have a lot of budget.
Here's the question I have. How is Don Granato worth four?
I was just going to say, could we hear those numbers again?
For yeah, Don that Granato? Kind of slid under the radar, too.
It's like, okay, well, yeah, a coach got fired, so he's going to continue to get paid. What was the term and the dollar on
a 2-year extension at $4 million each year? And that's basically what Sutter signed as well.
What the H?
Yeah, what has Don Granato done to...
Well, it looked like he turned it around last year, but he clearly hadn't. And I don't know why teams are so afraid to run a coach in his what they used to call lame duck years. It's very commonplace now. And like if the Flames had done that with Daryl, like God, you'd be in a way better spot.
Mr. Edwards would have saved a bunch of dough.
Yes, and then so would Mr. Pegula have. So I think there used to be this notion that, oh my goodness, if their coach is in his walk year, like lame duck, you can't have it. And it's like, no,
I'd
I think
be
you can absolutely
I'd be treating
have it.
It like a free agency.
I'd be saying, here's your chance to really wow me and get your bag.
Yeah. And I get why coaches would want it.
Sure.
If I'm the coach, I've got my agent or whoever does my negotiation. I'd have them in the GM or president's ear saying, you better get
me. I want to go back, not to interrupt you, but Pinder's take on this is too simple because it looked like he'd turned things around yesterday. That's how he jumped into $4 million.
$4 million.
We haven't played a playoff game.
Didn't make the playoffs. Yeah.
That's a hell of an agent again.
Wow.
Good agent work. That's like kind of your going rate for what I would call a top 10.
How good were they last year? They
missed the fucking playoffs.
That's how good. And Tage Thompson was the story of the league for a couple months at least.
It had felt like they'd turned it around, but the only caveat was that look at their division. They still have Boston, Florida, Tampa, Toronto.
That doesn't change next year.
And so that was sort of the like, wow, they could make it next year. And you're like, it's still... That's a shitty division to be bad in. Like you got to pass some really good teams if you're going to get in the playoffs.
I'd be
$4 million. Wow.
Anyway, good for him.
And no real head coaching experience prior.
He'd done a lot in America.
It was clearly not his. It would have been his third contract there.
Yeah.
So he's an interim guy. He gets a 2 or 3 year deal. And then with a year left, they give him this.
Because I'm thinking of guy. Remember, Alain Vigneault signed the deal. He got gas, but he'd been a head coach for a long time.
Been to the Stanley Cup finals a couple times. Like, this is, it's not even, that's what I'm getting at is
$4 million
sounds like a guy. Daryl signed for $4 million.
And Daryl's got the pedigree.
He's got two Stanley Cups and probably a Hall of Fame coaching career.
Like, yeah, I agreed. Yeah, if you want just the published salaries, like Jim Montgomery's only making two, and left Dallas under weird circumstances.
Jim had to come back and resurrect his name.
Peter DeBoer in Dallas, $4.25, 3 years. That's significant money. Again, doesn't seem like Don Granato's class.
Peter
That's a tier above. Mr. Undefeated in game sevens. Paul Maurice make it 3.9. So four's kind of like your top 10. You're an alpha coach, and I don't know that Don was there.
No.
$3 million for Marty St. Louis. That feels like an overpay. Peter Laviolette, 4.9 in New York.
What does Brindamore make?
It's not published because it's Carolina.
Because I was curious, right? Well-respected coach, 50 wins, 3 years running, but that coach...
Super cheap
that
owner.
Relationship with the owner there. I wonder what he makes.
It seems
published. Like whenever his deal comes up, he's got to go to bat for his staff, for everybody to get paid.
So Jackson like this. Tortorella makes 4 a year, 3-year deal.
Yeah.
Guess what Mike Sullivan makes in his new deal that kicks in next year?
5.5
for 3 years.
At least he has something.
Sullivan to the bank, not to the sun.
He's got a
cup.
He's got cups and success behind his name.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm not saying he's not worth it. It's just, it looked like a team that needed a coaching change this year.
I think that Red
and I are still stuck on the, how did Granato get?
No, I know. None of these are in the same category. And Bruce Cassidy, 4.5 years for 4 years in Vegas. Those are the only guys around four that is published.
There was a big push.
One of these things ain't like the other ones.
Coaches a whole bunch of money and get them paid. And remember Babcock's, we've been underpaid forever. I'm going to set the standard, blah, blah, blah.
And he did.
I don't know. He has, but
$40 million
is it going to come back a little bit? Because
I would just offer less term. Yeah.
Yeah.
You want $4 million? Sure. 2 year deal. Mm-hmm. And don't sign it a year before you get there.
Four.
Shelf life just isn't long enough, right? Like the whole, what did Babs have, an 8 year deal? Like that's just insane. Six year deal.
Yeah.
Like what? Which coach lasts that long?
Would you do it for $4 million?
Now? I would.
Well, how about three?
I think I will.
Okay.
How about you're in the West. You're going to have to travel more than
you want. I'm talking to go back to Buffalo. Pagula is like, I'm paying this coach not to coach. Well, I'm only going to go $1.5 million, $2 million on this next coach.
I'll do a 1 year deal, $500,000.
Half.
Ooh, the coaches are going to be pissed.
Jack, could we get Terry
Pagula? I got to establish myself. I got a show.
Yeah.
Like a podcast show?
Would
you still do the show when they hire you?
I would have to because I wouldn't make enough money. Right.
Now, are you still suspended by the Junior Sabre, the league, or whatever? Did you get that email thing all straightened out?
Good.
You can coach again? Yeah. Because you don't want that hanging over your head.
I know.
Terry Pagula comes calling. You know, Rhett, we're really interested in bringing you in, but it says here something about the whoop-de-doo tournament in Rochester. You flew off.
It was Port Huron, wasn't it?
Wasn't me.
Port Huron?
Boys were wound up.
Very disappointed with the behavior of this Buffalo Junior. Port Huron.
You know, Rhett, that's what we want out of our
senior
Sabres club.
That's what they need instead of
Rasmus Dahlin pops his shoulder out game one fighting. Damn it, Rhett!
No, they have catered to a bunch of guys that are soft.
Okay, so you're going to go in there. You're going to be the coach.
Who are you bringing?
Me and Ryan. What are we
going to do? No, I'm not.
Video. I don't want you on the bench.
I kind of want to be in the bench.
Your legs are going to get sore standing.
Like Jelly, remember when Jelly and I was on the bench? Just kind of,
what are you going to
have? Get her going, boys. Hey, let's get her going, boys.
Concessions.
Oh, come on, Red.
I just got a cooking show. I mean, what's wrong with concessions?
You're going to have to interview.
Jeez, no favors.
I'm not just going to hand it up.
Jeez.
Man. It's rough.
Who's on your staff?
I got to check my budget.
It's like DiCaprio having to read a script to get a gig.
I know what I would do and what Adams should have done and what St. I would go and get the bet. I would go get Vigneault or Quenneville and say, pay me. I'll have the title and I'll make $500,000 and pay him too to be my assistant because he knows what he's doing.
Right. Mm.
I'll learn
associate coach.
I'll learn a lot from this guy.
There you go.
Maybe Babs could be your assistant.
Because I'm a team guy. I'm about having success for the team. It's not about, Rhett could get a $4 million contract.
It's not about you.
I don't give a shit.
It's about the team.
Because we're going to win a Stanley Cup, and then Mr. Pagula is going to ride in with his billions and just dump it in the rink.
Mr. Kabuga is going to make us all rich. Listen to me.
It's going to be like one of those...
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Kabuga.
You get in the whirlwind thing with the dollar bills.
Yeah,
okay, you got 3 minutes in here, and they're hundos.
Thanks, Mr. Beluga. We love you. Let's go to the Eastern playoff chase. You saw it earlier. Shane Gostisbehere's hops save the Wings.
I'm on a roll here.
He is on a roll.
That's my salary. Once a week, I get 2 minutes in the whirlwind of cash.
Yeah, well, what bills?
And we'll do it.
American
live.
Hundreds? What are we doing?
It's got to be hundos.
American hundos.
Usually it's direct deposit into your checking. Yeah. This is Rhett going into the hurricane of hundos to grab as many, sticking them into your G string.
I can just see him. He's like, God damn, we had a big win last night. I'm hungover as shit. Oh, fucking shoulder. Oh, God, his damn shoulder's costing me $20,000.
I had like 8 of them and then I dropped
my
them.
My shoulder. As soon as I
left. Shit.
$100
Wings and Shane Gostisbehere.
Yeah.
Needed to stay alive. They did that. Impressive.
It wasn't for a while.
Yeah. And that, if you could just flip it 2 inches higher, you might win the game there. Lane Hudson, everyone in Montreal, very excited about him. He's NHL debut last night, 20 plus minutes.
American kid, NTDP.
he was the one trying to break up that 2-on-1 in overtime.
Yeah.
Busting back there.
Either way, the Wings win. They still aren't in. Washington won as well. Pittsburgh won as well. Stupid and we might Washington. Get the chaos extended for one more night beyond tonight. There's your look at it as it stands. One of those teams gets in. Just one. Ugh. Philly still alive. Torts, save your best speech ever for tonight, buddy.
It's hard when you get to this point of the season and you think about a point.
Oh, you go back over the season. You
a
go,
point.
You really? Think about a Ginla night for the Penguins here.
Oof. Yeah, they had it.
Just don't completely soil yourself in the last minute or something and find a point somewhere.
Yeah. Well, but and they blew that lead against Detroit earlier. They gave Detroit the loser point when they played, when Pittsburgh played them, what, a week ago, Jack? Yeah.
It's been a great season in most cities. Or at least for the observer.
And by the way, fan perspective. Look at the point totals here. Remember when we used to tell you about 95 points to get you in? Yeah.
That's got to be one of the lowest. In.
Yeah, big time. It's the Turtle Derby for sure. But good hockey still left. We'll see who gets in.
And then on the flip side, I saw, and I should have grabbed it, but I saw a tweet yesterday, a list of the players who would have won the Art Ross in 2015.
Oh,
with their point totals from this year. There's about 30 guys. Yeah.
Jamie Benn won it with 87 points 1 year.
Yeah, early. Jamie Benn. I think that was the year Benn won it. And it was, yeah, it's about 25, 30, like the
different league.
Tons of guys that would be, because I looked this morning, what was it? Panarin hit 140. He's the fourth guy to hit 140 points. Yeah, this
no
year.
One's had 100 helpers in the league for ages. Connor hit it last night. You're like, wow, what a feat. When will we see it next? Maybe on Wednesday.
Yeah, maybe on Kucherov Wednesday.
Needs one assist to get to 100.
Yeah.
Crazy. Tonight, let's look at the games. And Max Chaos. I think Elliot was tweeting about Max Chaos. If you're a Team Chaos, there's some games to talk about tonight. You need Philly to beat Washington, 5 o'clock start. You need a result from Montreal against Detroit.
Man, that's a big Washington Philly.
Isn't it huge? And then Pittsburgh's game tomorrow against the Islanders, who are already in and sealed, would be the win and you're in. And that would be the, if we could string this at the most high leverage games possible between now and the end of the year, that's how it has to go.
Now, I have a hard time keeping up with Jack and his strategies for how this works. Because he shits on the Penguins so that they play well, or he
said abandons they were all hope. And they won last night. He has no hope now because if he did, they'll lose.
Okay, so Jack, how do you feel about tonight? What's going to happen here with these games?
I feel good about Philly. Like, I think they come out. I think they beat Washington. The Montreal-Detroit thing. I don't know. Like, I feel like yesterday was the one they had to have.
They're up three.
Yeah. I don't feel good. I think, like I said, for a week, it's over.
It's beautiful. Something just that unbridled enthusiasm, the roller coaster.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, that's a tough one, right?
Clinch.
There.
Yeah, clench hard there, pal.
Tough.
We're all with you.
WHL, you want the update, right? Here it is. Buckle up. We got, a few series that aren't that close. Look at Portland's up 3-0 on Everett. Cougars up 2-0 on Kelowna heading back to the Okanagan. And the Blade's been a wagon. They dusted off Red Deer a couple times as the scene switches to Central Alberta.
Maybe we should go up to Red Deer, Dean.
Roads look great. Why not?
That's a good point. It's a little snowy.
Yeah. Now, is it at Billy Bob's? Is that Tuesday or Wednesday night?
Yeah, every night.
They could. Yeah. Well, no, they
I'm
do.
I'm not sure that Billy Bob's.
What, t-shirt once a week? I
can't remember. Let's
tie that in with it.
I'll look game. For you, Dean.
Thanks.
So
you guys don't go to Flames games, but you're going to Red Deer?
Yeah, what t-shirt night? Two birds with one stone. Well, yeah, come on. Daniel Jones?
What was I looking at?
Weirdo.
Billy Bob's.
Daniel Jones, weirdo. Quarterback, Giants?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Look at this.
Oy. Kind of just start off with the obvious. How are you doing in your rehab and where do things stand?
Rehab's going well. Making good progress, coming along. Obviously spent a lot of time with the trainers here and strength staff. So feel like things are going well. I'm coming along well.
Hey, is Daniel, like so then just to build on that, God. Have they given you a target date?
Like the when eyes are just dinner plates cleared? Here.
That's the look of a man
who
shit himself right before the press conference started.
This was you on the Christmas show.
This is him trying to sneak out a fart, shat himself, and it's like,
oh
my, OMG.
Right. Oh. I'm sitting in my own fecal matter.
Hi, Daniel. Wondering about the season.
Let's go check in on our boy Tim.
None of you act like you haven't been there. We know you've been there.
Tim.Nagy.
Let's go, Tim.
67. Going to blackjack and betting 10 cents for every Instagram follower I've got coming in off a 2-day hiatus. There are 780,000 of you in here now. So a $78,000 bet coming right up.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. Day 67. I don't love the look of our dealer. Kind of bloke who looks like he'd use iron covers on the golf course. Says a lot about him. The Adventures of Tintin merch gets a run. Three's disgusting. 12 plays a jack. Oh, can we pull one off again? We got away with one before the hiatus, and we are looking to escape an absolute hiding here. Go low for me. Take a 7, 8, or 9, please.
Give him a 9.
7! 7! Oh, so you're telling me there's a chance 19 plays a jack. 7, 8, 9 on his end now. Would get the job done. Return serve with a big fucking win. Go low! Yes! Yes! Come yes! On. Fucking yes! We've scraped in! It doesn't matter inch or mile. Vin Diesel said it best. It's a W regardless, and I will see you tomorrow after the Adventures of Tintin secured a W when we'll be betting even more.
He just doesn't lose. I
it's so great. 12 against the
nervous.
Jack.
I was nervous. 12 against the Jack. You're cooked.
Damn.
Jack, how's he doing this?
I don't know. Every hand he does gets a little more ridiculous. I'm starting to...
Are you doubting that it's legit?
What have the last three been? He's had like 12, 13, and then he hits like a low card.
Fours. He had the fours. Four. Yeah, 21, didn't he?
Well, didn't he have the one where it was... He just had 20? Didn't he get dealt
a
pair of face cards?
I feel like he's won four of his last five. I've yet to see him lose two in a row.
He has not lost two in a row.
Which, that's not me at the blackjack table. I don't know.
Listen, Jack, God, like, don't bring your negative shit to the show, Jack. Right.
Just stating facts. I've got no problem with Jack.
If there's going to be a sourpuss in here, it's going to be me, all right?
Whoa.
Like, I'm...
Stay on your turf.
I'm the sour prick in the room.
Lane.
Okay? We don't need two of us.
It's just the penguin stress talking. Sorry.
So what was 150-some thousand win there?
In your pocket.
156.
Attaboy, Tim.
Attaboy, Timmy!
This is not the time to start mojo, Jack. Yeah.
Don't forget where you broke the media curse. Right in that seat over there. Happy guy. That's where you were. Someone didn't know about Diet Coke and Mentos, but they found out the hard way. Oh no!
Yeah, it was another challenge, right? All right, I've had several requests to do this one. I'm going to give it a shot today. I would bet $200 I couldn't drink it. Anyway, we got Diet Coke and Mentos. I don't know how much to put in there, but we're going to try it like it's right there. We got to submit it like it's right here. We're going to open the water.
Idiot.
How about you supposed to put it in there? I don't know. So we don't put two in there. How about that? Oh, it did. Oh, listen. Here we go. You ready for this right here? Okay, we got to put three.
Three.
Okay, I don't know what to do here. Huh?
Oh, God.
Does that really happen?
That does. Have you ever done the Diet Coke and Mentos?
Is he?
That's some serious shit.
Is he without legs? This.
I don't know. He looks like he's sitting cross-legged, but I was sort of more focused on the Diet Coke fountain that he launched there.
Yeah, the Diet Coke or the I just have to be diet.
I think diet is
soft drink. Mentos is kind of the thing, right?
I think there's something in the diet version that is part of the chemical reaction.
This is going to be another great off season show. We're going to have
outside
a science
or if science we
fair. Barn burner science fair.
Yes, yeah, totally science fair. And if we have to move out of here, we go to a different studio the day before our lease ends. We'll do that here. Yeah. Otherwise, outside.
There's no room to do anything outside. It's construction. It's not safe.
It's going to be Beverly Hills, I'm sure, anytime now. Just waiting patiently.
But it looks good so far.
Really good. Yeah.
It's good mud. Like, my kids haven't lost their shoes in the mud before, and I'm thinking about bringing them
memories,
back.
Right? Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Back when we were kids, get a booter.
Mm-hmm. You have something in common
so
then.
Good.
Yeah. Not sure how this started, but look how it ends. got a boar. Now, I keep reading about these wild boars in the states here.
Look at Saskatchewan.
Sasky wild boars. Is he laughing?
So has he run the dude up the tree? Is that what's happened?
Yeah, no, he's just going to saunter off.
Nice friend. You going to help me? No, I'm going to get a video. I'll roll tape.
That is something you have to remember on these viral clips. What's the camera person doing?
Yeah.
That was not a trail cam that caught that one.
No, it was not. No. Is it still a thing in Saskatchewan?
Oh, yeah.
Still, hey?
Very hard to get rid of.
And they get smarter.
Now, guns are still legal in places where boars are? Like, are they that hard to get rid of?
You couldn't. In Texas, you can go shoot them from a helicopter, as many as you want, forever.
What does that cost? I'm into that.
No, that's a honestly, I think that's a thing that
they're running wild. The whole thing
is they get more wise as they avoid death, so that they're not going to be trapped a similar way again.
So boars are like the final boss.
They're like the final boss to give you the people's elbow.
That's right. Croc one, let's go to it. You know, when we have croc one, that also means so you got to check the pond before you go fishing, right? And that is, look at the pace and size of that. My God. That looks like a tepid pond with nothing in it.
I still feel like at some point we are going to exhaust the internet of crocodile videos.
I keep waiting for it, but
because it's too,
the more I doubt, the more I find is the irony of it all.
It's that's like a hind quarter that thing just
evaporated. It hammered it like a Tic Tac. This one is called Croc Kayak. Not the position you want to be on the Nile.
Are they scaring it away, or is this some?
I would worry. Kayakers got a raft together here. Stick together. Strength in numbers.
You know what?
Fuck you!
Oh boy!
Fuck up!
Is it an Aussie?
I saw that.
Sorry. It's okay.
No, that's all good, dude. Nice one.
Fuck, that was a big cut.
Fuck you. Just another country, Dean, where it's okay.
Always had hit him harder, man.
Fuck, that was a fucking bad croc, that, man.
Dude, the sign
there it is. There it is. There. It's like 10 o'clock to you now.
Yeah, that's 10 o'clock. Get out of here.
What are you doing?
Stay away.
Is it that important that you ride these rapids? Teamwork, make
the dream work. Shout out to them for standing their ground and fighting off the crocodile.
Yeah, yeah.
I just never understood.
Yeah.
Two thumbs up.
Now, are you warming up a little to these animals the more you see and learn about them?
Oh, I can't wait to get one for a pet. Yeah.
No, not at all. What about snakes? Because this guy loves snakes.
Thank you so much for all the amazing follows. I can't even understand how you guys are pulling up. Whoa! Man, these guys are giving me a hug.
Yeah, that can't be real, can it? That's not ideal. How are you? That guy died there, right? I'm just glad you're happy, Dean. You look happy there. Whatever pets keep you. Right state of mind.
You can get it off the screen now, Jack.
Those big snakes. Bill Chanda, Pinder Port.
Are we done?
That's how we go out with Dean and his pets. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out more of our content right here on the Flames Nation YouTube page. We had a bunch of great long form interviews. You can check out some videos we've done as well outside of the studio. And of course, if you want more writing or merchandise stuff, flamesnation.ca or nationgear.ca. Appreciate you watching.